I have left instructions that we do not want to hear that any of these killings or maimings or violence continues. And I'm sure that the heads of security who are here have taken that very seriously and intend to ensure that there is peace and that there is security. Of course, this is in the short term. In the, you know, in the medium to long term, we're looking at more permanent solutions to the problems of insecurity, and we've discussed several of those issues. Fortunately, we've had very, very robust discussions from all of the community leaders, and they have made their suggestions. We will look at how to implement several of those suggestions as we go along. Some include the permanent positioning of security agencies in certain communities that are prone to these types of violence. And we intend certainly to look at that request and to see how we can put in place permanent security, especially the police and in some cases military deployments in some of those places where violence tend to where flashpoints tend to be on a frequent basis. And we've agreed to some locations where these security deployments ought to be made. I think also we have looked at issues surrounding the, not just the recent killings, but also the killings that have taken place and some of the conflicts that have taken place in the past. One of the critical issues that was raised is the fact that there have people who have been dislocated from their villages and from their homesteads, and who have not returned to those villages and homesteads, and those villages and homesteads have been taken over. I think that that is a very serious issue, and it's an issue that the federal government, in collaboration with the state government, must take up, and which we will ensure that we take. Which will ensure we take up. I think a very important point that has also emerged from our discussions is that a lot of the crises are not a year old or 2 years old. Many of these crises are dated. They are, many of them are almost historical in terms of the number of years that they have continued to manifest themselves. Some, you know, have 10 years ago, some even much earlier. Than 10 years ago. And I think one of the most important issues that we need to resolve is that we cannot continue having this continuous cycle of killings and this continuous cycle of violence. And I think a point that was made very well made by His Excellency the Governor of KP is that we must all condemn killings of any kind. And it doesn't matter whether these killings are by herdsmen killing villagers, or whether it is villagers who, in one way or the other, have killed others, including herdsmen. I think it's important that we condemn this killing, in particular the killings that have taken place, where so many people have lost their lives in the past few days, which have been attributed to herdsmen. They are condemnable killings. They are, in fact, vicious and horrible, and there is no reason at all why anyone who commits these offences will escape. We will make sure. We will make sure that, and the Major General, the head of the Operation Save Him, as well as DIG Habila, have confirmed to me that some arrests have been made, and those persons will face the law. But that other arrests will be made. I think it's important, and that we ensure that there is justice. Those who have been killed cannot just be killed and we allow that to just go by. It is not acceptable at all. It's our duty to make sure that these individuals are prosecuted. And I want to be sure, and I want you to be sure that we will do so. We'll make sure that those who have been arrested are duly prosecuted, and that others who are engaged in this kind of, who are engaged in this heinous conduct are also arrested and prosecuted. Otherwise, I think that those are the main issues that we've discussed, except to say that it is our duty as leaders, as community leaders, to ensure that we do not allow a situation where these cycles of violence continue. As I've said to the community leaders, issues like this are dealt with and resolved by men and not spirits. It is those of us who are alive and well today, those of us who are leaders, community leaders, leaders of the state government, local government, and federal government, who must resolve these issues. And we cannot shy away from resolving the issues. And we must be bold enough to be able to tell our communities that resolving these disputes is a give and take issue. It's a give and take issue. There is no zero sum here. We have so many losses, so many killings, so many deaths over time. But we must find a solution. And the solution is in the types of sacrifices that leaders are prepared to make. Sometimes you may be unpopular with your community because you make some concessions. That is what leadership is about. The final point is with respect to relief materials. I think that we already, NEMA is here with me, and they will be ensuring that relief materials are provided. The DG of NEMA will ensure that that is done. Relief materials are provided in the various areas where they are required. We've also talked about the $10 billion fund, which the president approved, for mainly for the rehabilitation of farms and farming communities, the farmers in particular. Fortunately, we have the chairman of the Food and Security Council who is here with us, the vice chairman of the Food and Security Council, the governor of Kebbi. That fund is to enable farmers who have lost who have not been able to farm or who have lost farmlands to be rehabilitated, and we will provide for them inputs, will provide whatever assistance is required so that they can go back to their farms and go back to their farmlands. And this we're going to make available also here in Plateau State. Otherwise, those are the issues that have been talked about, and we hope and pray that we'll see an end to these cycles of violence. Again, just we've expressed our sincere condolence to all of those who have lost family and friends in this last spate of killings. I will pray that the Almighty God will console the families and relations of those who have lost their lives, and we pray that we'll never see again a repeat of these kinds of these killings and these deaths. Thank you very much.